days after her disappearance, volunteers are out on the streets looking for a woman with disabilities.
Tonight, family members remain hopeful she'll turn up. News 4's Myra Ruiz joins us now live from Fountain Inn. Myra.
Well, Nigel and Carol, Melinda Redfield lived at this group home behind me, and she hasn't had her seizure medication in 2 days.
She ain't got this far without somebody's help.
Iris Davis says she won't stop looking until her sister is home safe. Melinda Redfield is 4'10", weighs about 120 pounds, and was wearing a pink striped shirt and denim capri shorts when she was last seen Wednesday afternoon.
We keep a hope that we will find her.
Redfield has lived at this group home for the past year. It's run by the Greenville County Disabilities and Special Needs Board. The doors aren't locked during the day.
The important thing is that, you know, we have the staffing in place to provide that supervision, and what we call accountability levels are maintained.
They believe Redfield left in a 5 to 10 minute window period.
We really don't know if she just walked out the front door and just saw somebody. She's very friendly, and she got in a car with somebody.
For most of Thursday, firefighters and police joined Greenville County's emergency rescue team and others looking for Redfield. But the intensive ground search is no longer underway.
We've kind of exhausted the immediate area, and we really don't have a direction of travel. But we're going to continue to look. You know, we'll continue to look for Miss Redfield until we find her and bring her home.
Family members believe someone knows where she is.
Just call in. We want to know where our sister is. My mom want to know where her daughter is. You know, her son want to know where his mother is.